I was out two nights ago after the first shindig there at Music Thing and Ham's Sellers Market. And we were all out on the streets. I thought the cops were going to come. So I was out after that, and I was out with a group of people from Linden Lab, and we were talking about, of course, Second Life. And one of the guys, Sam, said something that is the title of the slide, basically. He said to me, we were talking about challenges we face, and he said, "You're not talking about evolution, you're talking about revolution." And then yesterday, I saw Byers put up this slide, and I had just seen these pictures recently, and they're very powerful, and a lot of people have been writing about them. And they're this thing about Detroit, you know, that Detroit has become such a photojournalist's dream right now because it's basically slowly returning to a wilderness as people essentially move out of it and as the patterns of industry change and leave Detroit, turning back into a garden, basically. And so there are these lovely pictures of Detroit. But I thought this abandoned building was really quite a powerful image to look at. And I think it's one that's really sort of fitting, at least to my thoughts about this. And what I mean by evolution and revolution is, I think that, and I want to talk about that a little bit, I think what Ray said, all the stuff that Ray said yesterday is stuff that is evolutionary in nature. I mean, it's an idea that the world sort of inevitably goes through these changes. Technology improves, that just causes people to do things differently, and really you can broadly see that as a sort of an evolutionary pattern, right? But the impact of those changes can be revolutionary, I think. I don't know that I really know what revolution means, but I think that Sam was making a fascinating point and struck me as telling that there is some difference between those two things. And I think what it means has something to do with where we are today with Second Life and also what it feels like to be in Second Life and what Ray was saying more broadly as we listened to him. And that is, let's step back for a moment and remember what the central idea here is. And the central idea is what I started the company to do. And I think that that original dream, that original idea, is exactly what's going on today. And it's a very big deal. And that idea is basically to digitize reality. To move from, or supplant, and therein lies that revolution issue, but to create an option where you reconstruct the entire world as we know it today in a digital form. And that, what everything that I see in Second Life today, and all the people that I've met here, and the new ones that I've met this year, suggests to me that that process, though slow and hard, and difficult, is underway. There are, as I've walked around here and as I've met people, there's more diversity than ever before. That is to say, we have business people here of a sort that we haven't had before. We have educators here in numbers, where before there was only a few of them. We have the same set of digital settlers and pioneers that we've always had, going stronger than ever, doing what they've been doing. That diversity of behavior suggests to me that the original mission of this thing is all proceeding according to plan. We really are in the earliest stages of digitizing everything.